We'll discuss today the making of the constitution. This is the next topic in a chapter. So just to discuss the making of the constitution, first of all, we'll see, all of us know that, let's see. I'm going to mute everyone. Okay, if you want to ask any question, if you want to participate in the discussion, so please you can unmute yourself and can ask the question to me if any confusion is there. So the making of constitution, the first meeting, first of all we'll see from where the proceedings started to make the constitution, to frame the constitution for India. The very first meeting took place on 9th
December
1946. Very good. Okay, this was the first meeting to be conducted for the proceedings of the constitution. And here, please keep remember one thing here, for the constituent assembly, the elections had taken place in July 1946 and the members of the constituent assembly were elected indirectly. Okay. So constituent assembly, the members of constituent assembly were elected by the members of the provincial legislative assemblies. We'll just know all these things. So we could say elections took place for what? Constituent assembly. Elections took place in July 1946, and the first meeting took place at 9th December 1946. In these elections, the members for the constituent assembly were elected. Okay. And elected members, elected members indirectly for Constituent Assembly, because all of us know who framed the Constitution of India. Constituent Assembly.
Constituent Assembly.
Very good. And this Constituent Assembly was the body of the members who were elected indirectly. Okay. And who elected them? Now the question arises. You know, we have seen that they were the elected members. And we are saying indirectly elected. They were not elected directly by the people, though they represented the people in the Constituent Assembly, but they were not elected directly by the people. Their election was indirect. So who elected them?
Provincial Legislative Assembly members.
Very good. They were elected by provincial legislative assemblies. What were these provincial legislative assemblies? Okay. These provincial legislative assemblies, all of us know, Before independence, the British has divided India into the different provinces. I hope all of you are very much aware of this. Okay. We had the princely states, we had the provincial legislative assembly. So British had divided the provincial India into the different provinces and the princely states, in fact. So these members, the members of the Constituent Assembly, they were elected by the members of provincial legislative assemblies who represented the people in the different provinces. ठीक है, who were the representatives of the people into the different provinces. These members elected the members of the Constituent Assembly. Now, what was this provincial legislative assembly? What was this? These assemblies were established. Let me know under which act these were established. Which was the act? Under which act the British established?
Government of India Act 1935.
Very 35. Good. Government of India Act. In short, I am writing this GOVT. Government of India Act 1935. What was this act? What were the provisions of this act? What was the importance of this act, in fact?
Ma'am, yes. Can I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, it gave provinces more legislative power.
More legislative powers.
To conduct elections also.
Yes, very good. To conduct the elections. Under the Government of India Act, all these provinces were free. Okay, they got the freedom to conduct the elections in their own provinces. So this is this was the value of the Government of India Act 1935, because this act first time gave the freedom to all the provinces to conduct the elections in their own provinces. Got it, everyone? So now we come back on the making of the constitution. Now we have come to know how was the Constituent Assembly, how were the members of Constituent Assembly elected. We have gone through this. Now we come back on the topic making of the constitution. Now we'll see how was it made. So first of all, the constitution was made, you should know, it was made on the lines of a plan. What was that plan?
Lord Mountbatten plan. No. Plan of 3 June 1947.
No. Constituent. How was the
cabinet mission plan? Cabinet mission plan.
Very good. How was the Constituent Assembly was formed? Okay, how was the Constituent Assembly formed? Okay. How many members will represent the people in the Constituent Assembly? Okay, all of these plans were proposed by the Cabinet Mission Plan. Please keep remember, important one marker. Okay, so Constituent Assembly was made on the lines of Cabinet Mission Plan. Was made on lines of Cabinet Mission. Cabinet Mission Plan. How many members were there in Cabinet Mission Plan? Anyone can tell me?
Ma'am, I think 290.
But 292? Cabinet Mission Plan, which Cabinet Mission came to India, okay? Its main function was to discuss the transfer of powers from the British government to the leadership of India. Okay? How will they transfer the powers
Indian government.
India, to the leaders of India? This was the main purpose to send this committee. And this cabinet committee prepared a plan which is known as the Cabinet Mission Plan, in fact. Okay, so who were the members of this cabinet mission plan? Anyone remember? Yes, who were the members of this cabinet mission plan?
Ma'am.
Yes.
The Prime Minister of UK.
Beta, give me the names. फटाफट names दीजिए मुझे. Three British cabinet members were there. Number one. ठीक है. Should I write?
Clement Attlee, Patrick Lawrence.
Patrick Lawrence, number one. है ना? Cabinet mission plan.
Clement Attlee.
It had three members. This was the three members committee. Three members in cabinet mission plan. Number one was the Lord Patrick Lawrence. He was the Secretary of State.
Secretary of State for India. Yes.
Patrick Lawrence was there. Okay. Second was Sir Stafford Cripps had been there. And third member was, just please note down,
Mr.
A.V. Alexander.
Mr. A.V. Alexander.
Clement Attlee.
Yes. A.V. Alexander. Cabinet mission plan was proposed by these three, and these three were the members of the cabinet mission to India. What was the purpose of the cabinet mission to India? The main intention was to come to India to discuss the transfer of powers from the British government to the leadership of India. How will they transfer the powers? And they gave the following recommendations. Number one, they recommended that India should form a federation. India should be divided into the different federations. Secondly, the central government should be in charge of foreign affairs, defense, and communication. Okay. Third, they recommended that the provinces and the states should enjoy all the powers. These were the recommendations provided by the cabinet mission. Besides this, according to this plan, okay, they provided a method to elect the members of the Constituent Assembly. How will the people represent themselves in the Constituent Assembly? Now we'll see that method. Have you noted down all the recommendations of the cabinet mission plan? Anyone can repeat, please? Yes, recommendations of the cabinet mission plan. Anyone?
Ma'am, first one is that India should be divided into many federations.
Very good. And second, anyone else? Second, the central government should be in charge of foreign affairs, defense, and communication. Third, the provinces and the states should enjoy all the powers. Okay, so all these were the important recommendations provided by the cabinet mission plan to India. Besides this, they provided the provisions how to elect the members, or how will the people represent in the Constituent Assembly. Now we'll see the method. Okay. So the provisions they provided, I'm just writing this under the heading of provisions. Provisions. What were the provisions? Number one. First provision was cabinet mission plan provided that the allotment of seats would be on the basis of population in the ratio of 1:10. This is the very, very basic concept in political science. Please understand this. We'll discuss this in detail. ठीक है, हाउ आर द पीपल इलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट प्रोविंसेस और फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट असेंबलीज. ओके, सो फर्स्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल डिस्कस फर्स्ट प्रोविजन. इट वॉज अलॉटमेंट. इन शॉर्ट आई एम राइटिंग दिस अलॉटमेंट ऑफ सीट्स on the basis of population in ratio of what would be the ratio as per them, in ratio of it would be one member would be allotted a seat on the population of 10 lakh. On the population of 10 lakh. First of all, we'll discuss this. Now see, you will see the proceedings of the elections also. You will get it. How do the elections take place? Because everyone cannot be elected. Everyone cannot contest the elections even. So what's the criteria? Okay. So first of all, cabinet mission plan proposed that the seats would be allotted on the basis of population in the ratio of 1:10 lakh. This was the first provisions. Now understand this point first. See, in the constituent assembly, okay, so according to this British provinces, first of all we'll see the number of total members before partition total members in constituent assembly. How many members were there? Before partition?
389.
They were 389. Now understand this. They had to elect the 389 members for the constituent assembly. Now what would be the method? Okay, just they demarcated this number of 389 like this. Number one, how will they elect? Number one, provincial councils, in short I'll write this PROV, provincial legislative councils will send, in short legis, I'm writing legislative councils, they will send 292 members. How many members are left? Now, secondly, princely states. Princely states will send 93 members. Yes, princely states. How many members will princely states send? 93 members. Now, how many members are left? Okay, 389.
Four.
Are these 389?
No, ma'am. It's 385. Four members are left.
So these four members would be elected from the Chief Election Commissioner.
Was also the
kind of constituent there. Chief Election Commissions had been there, commissioners had been there. Okay, they will send Chief Election Commissioners. Out of them, they will send four members. Now, is this 389? Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Now, this is done. Check it out, please. Now, this is total 389. Now, how will these members be elected in the ratio of 1:10 lakh? 1 to 10 lakh people. Now you just tell me, I'll ask you. You just tell me, suppose we discuss one example to see this. one example we'll discuss. You just tell me, suppose we take the example of Madras. We take the example of Madras had been a province, and the population of Madras is, suppose Madras population is 1 crore. Suppose population is 1 crore. I'll write this in numbers so that we could get the things easily. 1 crores. This is 1 crore. Have I written right? Got yes, it? No. Madras population is 1 crore people. Now you tell me, how many members will Madras send to the Constituent Assembly? How many members would be elected from Madras?
Ma'am, 10.
Why 10? Very good. Well done. Who answered?
Ma'am, Yashashvika.
Very good, Yashashvika. Well done, beta. Have you even got it? How did she calculate that Madras will send the 10 members? Very good. ठीक है, सो 10 सीट्स
विल गो डिवाइडेड द रेशियो.
वेरी गुड. 1 करोर पॉपुलेशन है एंड व्हेन विल डिवाइड इट बाय
10 लाख.
डिवाइडेड बाय 10 लाख, सो व्हाट वुड बी द नंबर?
विल गेट 10.
वेरी गुड. देन विल गेट 10. तो इट मींस मद्रास विल सेंड द 10 मेंबर्स. मद्रास प्रोविंस विल इलेक्ट द 10 मेंबर्स and they will represent the people in the Constituent Assembly. Okay. Just to all of you, tell me, suppose Bombay, we take the example of Bombay. At that time, this was Bombay only. Bombay's population is 50 lakh. Suppose 50 lakh people had been there. How many members will Bombay province send to the Constituent Assembly?
Five.
Very good. Well done. Who answered? Very good. 5 members, yes, they will elect. Okay. Understand this concept, because when we'll discuss elections, again and again, all these things will come there. Then all of you ask me, madam, how will they be elected? How will the people be represent in the assemblies? Okay, just let us know. So we are clearing all the basics in chapter 1 only. Okay, once you got the concept, how are the seats allotted? Even today in India, the seats are allotted in the proportion of the population, and this is the method, in fact. Okay, so if Bombay's population is 50 lakhs, so how many members will Bombay elect and send to the Constituent Assembly? 5 members. Getting it? Okay, suppose Calcutta. We take the example of Calcutta. Calcutta's population is... Suppose Calcutta's population is 30 lakh. 30 lakh people are there. Suppose. How many members will Calcutta send?
Three members.
Very good. This is not uniform. Are you observing one thing? That this is not uniform. That every province will send the 10 members. The criteria was population. So only how many members will send? 3 members only.
3.
I hope the thing is clear. Now have you get?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so like this, in the proportion of the population, like this, how many members would be sent by the provincial legislative assemblies to the Constituent Assembly? 292. Got it, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Now we'll see the second point. Now see, second provision. This was the first provision, and I hope that the first provision is very much clear to each and everyone. Got it? 93 members would be elected from the princely states. We'll discuss this at last. This was the last provision of the cabinet mission plan. Okay, and 4 members would be out of the chief election commissioners. Now we'll see the second provision. What was the second provision now? Second provision was
ma'am, seeds were distributed among the three main communities.
Very good. We'll see this also.
That is Muslim, Sikh, and general.
Very good. Very good. Now, can you explain this? Can you tell me with examples, please? Can you explain this with example? As we have discussed the one of the example, can you explain me how will they elect the how many members will go out of the Muslims, out of the Sikhs and the general? Anyone, please?
Ma'am, can I?
Just wait. Let me write down. I'll just write.
Okay, ma'am.
So what was the second provision? Till then, you can note down. You can prepare, please. Okay. And second provision was that the seeds will be distributed mainly among three main communities. They divided them in the three main communities. What were these communities? Number one,
Muslims.
Very good. Number one, Muslims.
Six. And general.
Six and general. Just explain better, please. Sorry to interrupt you, but I just wanted that I must write the point first. Just beta, explain. Who's going to explain?
Ma'am, me.
Yashaswika?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Yes.
Ma'am, if, for example, in a province, if we take the example of Bombay, there is a population of Muslims equal to 1 crore. And then if we follow the same method that we used previously, then we divide this 1 crore population by 10 lakh. Mm-hmm. And by dividing this, we will get 10 members of Muslim community. And similarly, for the other communities, we will get the members like this.
Okay. We have to see the population of each group, each caste group.
Okay, we'll have to find out the population of each and every communities, and accordingly they will send these members who will represent the Muslim community, the Sikh communities and the general. Now suppose we'll take the example here. Okay, we take one example. Suppose, again we'll understand this. Suppose Bombay. Suppose we take the example of Bombay. Bombay's population is 50 lakh. Suppose 50 lakh people are there. Out of these 50 lakh, now from Bombay, we have to send the members who could represent the Muslim community, Sikh community, and the general community. Bombay has all the three. So first of all, Bombay province will see what's the population, general population, kitni hai. In short, I'm writing this GEN, general population. And population, in short, I'm writing POP, general population, is equal to, suppose, this is equal to 30 lakh. Suppose. 30 lakh. So how many people from general category would represent in the Constituent Assembly for Bombay?
Three.
Three.
After that, suppose Sikh population is 10 lakh. Sorry, or we can say
20.
10, maan lete hain, chalo, 10, because we have to give the representation to Muslims also.
Muslims
also. Sikh population is, in short, I'm writing POP. POP. Suppose this is 10 lakh.
Only one will represent.
Okay, very good. So one member will represent the Sikh population. In the same way, 30, 40,
Muslim.
And 10 would be, 10 lakh would be Muslims.
Okay, one from Muslim.
Muslims population. So, how many members will represent Muslims community?
One.
One.
One again. Okay. So like this, from Bombay province, how many members will go in the Constituent Assembly to represent the people to Bombay?
Five.
Very good. 3, 4, and 5 members. Got it? And the total population was 50 lakh. As per this also, our calculation is absolutely fine. Okay, as per the ratio of population of 50 lakh, because population is 50 lakh. So total, how many members have to represent in the Constituent Assembly for Bombay? 5 members. Yes. And when we demarcated it into the different communities, Muslim, Sikh and general, even though we got 5 members. Got the point? Interesting. Yeah, say something.
Ma'am, I had a doubt.
What?
Ma'am, yes. In Muslims have the Muslim people, Sikhs have the Sikh people, and in general, there are like those also
others were the part of general population.
Like Jains, Buddhists.
Yes, yes. Everyone. Whosoever had been there except these two communities, rest of the people were clubbed in the under the head of general population. All the others except these two, besides these two. Okay. So they had to represent themselves in the Constituent Assembly. I hope the things are clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Got it? Should we move to the third method, the third provision? Same method we adopt even today. Getting it? As per the number of populations, okay? And all these will discuss in the legislature, all these will discuss in the election. Got it? Now we move to the third provision of this. Third provision was, what was the third provision? Third was members of each community in the provincial legislative assembly elected their own representatives by the method of proportional representation with single transferable vote. The third provision was given by the cabinet mission plan that all these members would be elected on the basis of, by the method of proportional representation with the single transferable vote. Now we'll get this, what do we mean by single transferable vote and what is the proportional representations. So these members would be elected by the method of number one, proportional representation. And second, single transferable vote, voting system, point B. I'll explain both these here only, and please just note down. Reason is this, all these would be repeated again and again. When we'll discuss legislatures, when we'll discuss executives, when we'll discuss the elections. Again and again, all these would be repeated. So understand all these basics here only, note them down. At that time, I'll give you the reference that we have already discussed all these in the chapter one. Please consult from there. And second was single transferable voting system. So this would be the method of electing the members to the Constituent Assembly. Now, what was this, the proportional representations? hardly few seconds are left. I feel that I must start it tomorrow.